All right, and welcome to a quick transition into our next match here. Thank you to Dolan and Doomsday for giving us a great cast on Germany versus Romania, but we're moving back over into the next match quite quickly here. It's going to be United Kingdom versus Finland in the loser's bracket. I'm this one guy, and joining me for what I believe is his debut in the OWC commentary box is going to be none other than Fiery Rage. Welcome, Fiery. How's it going today, my guy?
Oh, it's going all right. I'm just chilling right now for the most part, but yeah. My first cast on OWC missed the round of 32 and round of 16 weekends, but here now, ready to cast hopefully onwards from the quarterfinals weekend here. Let's see how that goes. But yeah, United Kingdom versus Finland. You said it yourself, loser's bracket matchup for this one. Should be quite interesting, I believe. If I'm correct, these teams are relatively seated close to each other?
Yes, this is a 20th versus 23rd seed matchup. United Kingdom kind of dropping down a little bit from their normal high seed position this year with some big team changes to their roster. Finland, you know, I think typically expected to be somewhere around the 18 to 24 region, usually one of those teams that can maybe win a match, maybe put a scare into some top teams, but typically not a competitor for the overall win. But I think they are going to be a competitor for UK today with all the roster changes that they underwent this year. I think they match up more closely together than they may have in the past.
We'll see how it plays out for them. UK got here via losing to Canada in the round of 16. Finland dropping out in round of 32, losing to Indonesia first round, then beating Sweden 5-1 in the round of 16 losers bracket matchup.
Yeah, that was an interesting matchup to see, the Finland versus Sweden Nordic matchup. And Finland took it pretty handily. Sweden, another team, I guess, you know, that lost out on some of their peak performers from past years with this year's roster. So unfortunate to have seen them go that way, but it allowed Finland a nice win. And we'll see. I know there's some interesting circumstances surrounding these teams for this match, involving like who's available for their teams. I think UK might have a couple of players missing, Finland possibly as well, not sure. I think Finland is all here, but I know UK is not expected to have everyone. So we'll see if that ends up playing a role in today's matchup. I think they have some interesting skill sets to play off against each other. UK, you know, very good at the speed if they have their speed players. Finland, a little more away. I feel like a little more of a nomad team from what I've seen from them in the past matches.
Yeah, I'd be inclined to agree with that. I imagine UK is probably just going to be sticking with that speed. Probably going to be seeing the nomad 2 potentially, but more than likely DT2, DT3, free mod 2. Probably going to be guaranteed picks, and I would not be surprised to see Finland ban out one of those. In any case, though, we're already done with the roles. Finland banning second, UK banning first, and never mind, goodbye. No mod 2 is gone.
It's interesting to see. UK, obviously, a super strong tapping team, but they don't want to play this Nomad 2 for whatever reason. They had it actually banned against them last week by Canada, so a little confusing. I think they won Nomad 2 in their first week, if memory serves, against Norway. So very strange to see that ban, unless they just think Finland's good at Nomad 2. I don't really know.
Hidden 3 ban from Finland as well, so keeping the speed open for now. We'll see if their second ban goes for... Nope, okay, Nomad 3 has their second ban, so speed is left open entirely.
Yeah, that means that Finland... I guess that means that Finland thinks they can contest things like DT2, DT3... Free mod 2 that you're kind of listing off previously. Kadzak saying wait. Okay, not actually sure what's happening in chat there. Little confusion possibly in the lobby with the number of bans and the order of the bans. Hopefully that can get rectified and there aren't any issues. But we await UK's second ban, assuming there's no problems, which I don't know what to expect after they banned Nomad 2.
Yeah. If they banned Nomad 2, if they're not feeling the tapping right now, then potentially, I guess, we could see a DT2 ban, but I'm not too sure that'd be a good idea, necessarily. I feel like just banning more than Nomads would probably be better, but it's going to be Freemod 3. It's the second ban for the UK, and I mean, I could see that making sense. Finland does have a relatively strong gimmick roster to their name.
Yeah, getting rid of the small circle, low approach rate Freemod, if you're wanting to avoid gimmick, that's two very different bans, but if you want to avoid that skill set, then makes sense. Also, I'm curious, you know, thinking about the Nomad 2 ban and the potential other picks and bans for the United Kingdom, I'm curious if Malteser is here, because I heard that he may or may not be, and he's one of their main speed roster players, so that opens things up if he's indeed gone for this match, kind of in Finland's favor, because that's one of the big skill sets that was really favored toward the United Kingdom, with Malteser and Majora being as strong as they are in those maps. Looks like it's going to be a double time four, not double time three, double time four, first pick. So that's Flowering, which is the 222 BPM, very finger control tapping intensive air 10.3 DT pick to start things off. That's being picked by Finland.
Not too speedy for this one, which is kind of not what you expect in a double time pool. A lot more alt-oriented focus on this pick. I believe 225 BPM on this, or just about around that. But primarily focused on alt, only, I believe, clocking out at 5 note bursts at best. Not really too much of a speed requirement for this one.
Yeah, less about the speed, more about, I think, like, the finger control aspect of it, because you kind of have those repeating, like, doubles and triples in certain sections of this one, so you do have that kind of coming into play, but it's not going to be really testing your raw speed for players who are, you know, competent at tapping. It's not going to be a struggle in that sense. So this is an interesting way to start off this match, I think, as a Finland first pick against this United Kingdom team, because it's not raw speed, which is UK's forte, but it is tapping, which is UK's forte. So Finland saying, we can compete with you guys on that.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes for them. Seems like everyone is ready in the lobby. I think you are right. They are, I think, missing a couple of their speed players. I'd expect Malteser would be in for this, but not present on the UK side.
Yeah, it's going to be Lystia, Majora, Kingling, and Rouge. I would have expected Malteser over Kingling if you were here. Freeze, Amacetic, Jamin, and Zeppe on the Finland side. Map number one here. Winner goes on. Loser of this match is eliminated from the tournament, as we are in the loser's bracket here. So a lot on the line with this one. And we're going to get started, thrown right into a map that does not let up in this DT4 pick, and early breaks from the entire bottom row of players. I'm just going to be watching.
Yeah, relatively equal for now with those breaks at the bottom. Top row still holding for now. Slight accuracy advantage in favor of Finland in the early stages of this map here.
It's a small combo advantage to Finland as well. Those Zeppe breaking means that the combo advantage will go over to UK, but there goes Lystia as well. So it is now 2 FPCs to 1 in favor of Finland backing combo. Slightly higher in that regard as well. Majora still looking strong with the FC for the UK, but Freeze and Amacetic are comfortable enough in matching him, with Jamin bringing up a nice 600 combo, only about 50 combo off the FCs with his backing score.
Backing scores from Ridge and Kingling as well on the UK. Majora just unlucky slider break during the slow section. Just like that, that combo advantage is vastly in favor now of Finland. Freeze does trade but Rudge trades as well. The only high combo now, Kingling on the side of the United Kingdom, facing off against Amin and Amacetic.
And there goes Kingling as well. It's Lystia alone, Rudge falling too, and that two-player combo, make that just one. It's Amacetic on the FC, but that's going to be enough to hold this lead.
There comes the FC.
Okay, all right. Well, I'm sorry, Amacetic. My bad, bro.
The score gap is more than enough, though, from those combos alone. Only about a fourth of the map remaining. 400k. No combos on the side of the UK to really counteract that, aside from Majora, which is now gone. Goodbye, Majora. And a solid first pick for Finland here.
Yeah, a couple of these UK players having a little more trouble with this map than I would have expected them to, but also Finland putting up a very solid score here. It's going to be around 750k for Amacetic. A little bit behind that for the others with the big combos. Zepe taking, you know, pulling up the rear, but it's a 500k lead and a 500k win for Finland. And that is a good way to start off a match where you are kind of perceived as the underdog. Get a good, solid first pick that was really never in doubt in your favor. So that's 1-0 for Finland on their first selection. It'll go over to the UK.
So follow up immediately with a Hard Rock 2 pick. The precision oriented pick. Espresso C, I'm not saying that number.
Yep, it's Espresso. Mapped by Cloyd, well-known precision mapper. These small circle-sized Hard Rocks are kind of his hallmark. About 2.5 minutes long, 150 BPM. Kind of tricky in the sense of requiring that precision aim and finger control. This is, of course, a custom from Coffee Hispanic Tournament 2021. Always nice to see customs getting repurposed in other tournaments because they're high quality a lot of the time, and this is no exception.
Floyd has always been known as a CS5 mapper. Pretty well renowned at doing those types of maps and doing it very well. So it's unsurprising to see Cloyd in a lot of Hard Rock pools across several different tournaments. This map is no exception. Pretty difficult, actually, on this one. Low BPM, 150 BPM, but there are a lot of snap aim oriented patterns which can throw you off pretty easily. A lot of abrupt spacing changes, which at CS 6.5 can be very detrimental.
Does look like the players are set to go, so we'll see how well they can handle those tricky aim directional changes, that snap aim that you alluded to. We've got Kingling, Majora, Plasma, Rouge. So Plasma is here for UK, maybe only missing Malteser, hard to say. Freeze, Amacetic, Tikkanen, and Zepe going to be the roster for Finland. We'll see if UK can have as comfortable of a first pick as did Finland. They would like to, you know, just kind of ease their way into the match here with a nice back-to-back picks, one for the teams. That comfort level getting into matches is always nice to have. So we'll see if it plays out that way for the UK here.
I think all eyes are on Kingling and Majora on this map in particular. Kingling is well known to be a stellar Hard Rock player in his own right, especially in tournament. Majora also. If we're going to be seeing high combos, it's probably going to be coming from them on the side of the United Kingdom.
And over on the side of Finland, you already see three breaks. Amacetic, Zepe, and Tikkanen all breaking within the first 250 combo, leaving only Freeze as their bastion of defense against the quad FC. Still intact here for the United Kingdom. As you mentioned, Kingling Majora leading the way, but Plasma and Rouge also holding to the FCs with pretty reasonable accuracy as Majora finds first break, but it's traded by Freeze and Tikkanen.
And looking to be a very strong pick just off of the first third of the map alone. No real combo aside from Amacetic on the side of Finland. And, well, there goes that combo immediately. As soon as I say it. Classic.
You spoke that break into existence.
Classic.
There goes Zepe, who had the second best combo. And there goes Kingling, who is the precision extraordinaire player for the UK. But fortunately, they're already up by 500k, so that's not going to be the end of the world. As Plasma is still holding an FC, and Majora and Rouge are building some combo back up.
Yeah, Rouge as well breaking, but Plasma now just holding on to the combo. As we get into the hardest part of the map, chorus here. I guess you could call it the chorus. This is where the snap aim just goes crazy.
Yeah, that snap aim combined with the small circle size makes this so difficult in the section. You can see it catching everyone out. Kingling, Majora, Freeze, Damascenic, Zeppe, all breaking in that section pretty close to one another. Plasma, though, the
Let's
revelation
go, Plasma.
Here. What a score he's putting up. Yes,
okay.
He can. All right.
This is kind of crazy from Plasma. All right. Not really expecting this out of him on a CS 6.5 map, but he is just going to town on this. He loves this map.
He hits the squares, he hits the triangle, he hits the slow jumps, he pulls off the full combo for the United Kingdom, leading the way to a very resounding 800,000 point, nearly 900,000 point win on their own first pick. Plasma, that's a play and a half right there. One of the newcomers to this United Kingdom OWC roster showing up and making his presence felt.
390k to FC.
Yeah, Osu will do that to you, though. How many times do you see, you know, you get a not-so-great score in practice and an FC in match, or vice versa, you FC in practice 6 times in a row and then you drop a hot 500k in the match? It's just hoping to get that high roll when you need it, and that's what he did right there.
In any case, solid first picks from both of these teams. 1-1 scoreline Finland with the next pick. It's going to end up staying within the sort of gimmick-oriented pool. DT4, somewhat gimmick, I'd say, but not too gimmick. This, on the other hand, very much in that gimmick category. Very rhythm-oriented map on this one.
Yes, the gorilla mapped by Handsome. You, I feel like all you need to do is look at the name of this art, this artist, the song name, and the mapper, and you're like, I'm getting something that's not normal here. There's just no way this was ever going to be a straightforward type of map, and it is indeed not.
Best way to describe this map, I think, would be semi-alt and semi-what you'd expect a Nomad 6 from previous OWCs to be. It's a lot of alt-oriented patterns in this map, as well as a lot of rhythm changes. Lots of one-third rhythms in this.
Yeah, this is kind of this new direction, I think, right, of Nomad 5's, formerly Nomad 6, it's kind of the slot replacement this year, that are rhythmically oriented, but not necessarily always in the same way as, you know, your old, like, Devious Panda or Down Nomad 6's used to be. These are maybe a little more friendly while still retaining that rhythm-heavy requirement to them, which I think makes for more unique and very interesting picks a lot of the time.
Yeah, we've seen this map conceptually easier, so a lot of FCs on this, but we've also seen a lot of teams opt to try and prioritize accuracy on this, which in the end leads to a couple of misses as well. So despite this being conceptually one of the easier maps in the pool to get an FC on, I've seen a lot of people just miss all over the place on this, trying to play this properly.
Yeah, with the slider aim being somewhat tricky, as well as some of the rhythm changes being difficult, you can definitely see how easy some of these patterns can be to break on. But as you said as well, also an easy map if you were competent on this skill set to hold a big combo on, as nobody broke in the first 400 combo until, well, there goes Lystia, and I don't know, is it pronounced with a soft J, or is it Jamin, Hamin? I don't actually know, but that Finnish player broke as well.
I think it's Jamin. Madge, nope, as well. Majora going to be dropping in this first chorus. Not answered by anyone on the Finnish side for now. This is where we get into a bit more of the alt-oriented patterns. A lot of back-and-forth jumps here, which are pretty easy to miss on. There's one in particular coming up right here, I think.
You're gonna see.
No one's actually missing on that.
Got a break from Majora as well as a break from Rouge, followed up by one from Freeze. So it is Dezku and Amasetic holding the full combos. Once again, Plasma maintaining the FC for United Kingdom, but unfortunately does not have the backing score that they would need to try to bring this gap down.
Two FCs, the one halfway through the map. Break from Jammin. Keep things still somewhat tight. The break from Amasetic, though, going to matter way more. It's one of the FCs down. Rouge does trade it. Lystia as well to follow up with a break of her own.
That makes it Plasma and Majora essentially against Dezku and Freezed with very, very similar combo. Slightly better accuracy on Plasma than on Dezku, but slightly better accuracy on Freeze than on Majora, so this is going to stay pretty close. 100k, the gap, and the backing combo is in favor of Finland, so that's not going to be going anywhere too soon. Get to the break, and it is just about 90,000 points with a quarter of the map to go, and this is still anyone's map. Depending on how everyone plays the ending section that we're going to get into right now.
Pretty much any miss from any of the players at this point can easily shift the score gap over.
Or they can just all combo. Okay, there go Rouge and Lystia.
I don't think they're comboing it anymore. And there goes Plasma just like that. Score gap is now over 100k and growing for Finland to get into the ending here.
Well, it came down to the wire, and then all of a sudden everything just kind of exploded, and Finland are going to take what looks on paper like a more comfortable couple hundred thousand point win than it really felt like as a viewer through the first three quarters of this pick, where it was on a knife's edge. Once we get to the ending, it's going to end up being like 300,000 points thanks to these big ending combos from Dezku and from Freeze. So well done to Finland. 2-1, still no break points to the first three maps. Both teams looking relatively confident on their own picks, though that one was a little shakier.
Back from Amasetic and Lystia, just unfortunately getting some unlucky one misses. Plasma with the unlucky slider break as well. Was Finland's pick, though. UK to follow up with their own pick.
We'll see. You know, do they maybe go another Hard Rock? They've got a couple options in that pool still. Do they maybe feel like they can try out a speed? Nope, they just go another Hard Rock. It's Hard Rock 3. It's our original song. Custom created for this tournament, Side Quest by Redside. Nice little tech Hard Rock here.
This map is so fun to play, man. This is a very reminiscent of, I'd say, Nomad 4's. A lot of slider heavy aim on this pick in particular. Just adding on Hard Rock to that, so you have the higher circle size and the higher approach rate and OD to contend with.
I like this. I took one look at this map and I just immediately fell in love with it. It's so nice. Like the way everything flows and the way it fits the song is, I think, really, really well executed. Very big fan of this. And when you consider how Hard Rock 2 went for the United Kingdom, I think it makes a lot of sense for them to have gone into this as their next pick. Reminiscent of a map that I'm trying to remember the name of and having trouble remembering the name of that I've also seen as a Hard Rock tech map. I want to say it was in USC, but the name is escaping me. At any rate.
There have been a lot of Hard Rock tech maps, to be fair, so.
Yeah, it's tough. It's Moonheart. That's the map I'm thinking of. Moonheart.
I don't think I've actually heard of that.
The Captain One set. I think it was in USA States Cup a year or two ago. Anyway, it's another like it's another kind of flow aim slider tech map that gets used in Hard Rock Pulse. Also, just as a note, I have been informed that the player we were trying to figure out the name of is pronounced basically like Yamin. We know going forward.
Thank you.
Thanks to Shadoos, our resident Finnish expert. But we're going to get into a map that he is not going to be playing. It's going to be Majora Lystia Kingling Rouge against Freezed, Zeppe, Amasetic, and Dezku.
Three-minute long Hard Rock map. Slow beginning, which will immediately pick up into some fast slider aim sections. That's where you're probably going to be seeing a couple of misses here and there as players get adjusted to it. Or on the slow slider. That works too.
It just gets slow slidered. I was going to say that this was an interesting one in the earlier match, Brazil versus Ukraine, where you had Ukraine ahead, but Korean Maluko holding a giant combo that brought them back into it. Just the consistency on maps like this can be kind of tricky for people who aren't 100% comfortable with this sort of Hard Rock tech. And we're seeing some early breaks that indicate maybe these players are not quite, as you said, they got to kind of ease their way into this pick and become comfortable with it over time.
Yeah, repeated breaks from Majora and Kingling. Lystia as well, only one FC on the side of the UK in the early stages of the map. Countered by Amasetic. Combo advantage is still in favor of Finland. Zeppe not too far behind with the 400 combo.
We've got Amasetic and Zeppe. And really, there's just not a second combo for the United Kingdom. So far, they've typically had an answer to, you know, a main combo and a backing combo, but that is not the case on this map. Already halfway through. That lead is not very big, though. So if Amasetic or Zeppe breaks, it really opens the door for the United Kingdom here. But we are going to get back into another drop section, and it's going to become much more difficult again in the back half of this map.
The accuracy on the FCs is what's making, I think, most of the difference alongside Zeppe's combo right now. 3% accuracy lead for Amasetic. It's helping keep the score gap in their favor as we get into the last hard part here. Third of the map remaining. Still relatively close. 100k points of difference. And Rouge. Well.
That break may have just sealed the UK's fate on this pick. There's a late miss from Dezku, but it's Amasetic and Zeppe that are the ones that matter. Even with freeze break. Okay, there goes Amasetic. There is a little bit of time here. There's a decent amount of combo at the end. And Lystia and Majora were building up no longer Lystia, but still Kingling and Majora. And now just Kingling. Okay, nobody can hold, I guess.
Yeah, and Zeppe just has far and beyond more combo than Kingling here. I think this is pretty set in stone for Finland. Zeppe does find a break. So we'll be getting a bit close at the end here, but I just don't think there's enough time nor enough combo on the side of the UK to really make a dent in the score lead.
If Lystia and or Majora could have held through that last section, this could have gone UK's way. But even with Kingling and Rouge holding at the end here, it's just not going to end up being enough, unfortunately. And Finland are going to take the first break point of the match by about 140,000 points. That was always kind of in their favor, like we were saying. UK just didn't have a second combo for a lot of that pick, and Finland had Zeppe and Amasetic holding for a very, very long time. And the scores reflect that. 639k, 677k, with nobody over 600k for UK. That kind of spells disaster, and it spells a break point for Finland. They will take a 3-1 lead into their next pick.
Off that break point, Finland have lot of room to maneuver around here. They could continue going with some of the more gimmick-oriented stuff. Considering that pick went well for them, Hard Rock 3, I would not actually be surprised to see them just pick into Nomad 4 here. More or less the exact same type of map, just a lot more focused on general tech consistency over, like, raw slider aim entirely.
Yeah, this Nomad 4 is, yep, I was gonna say, is a very good shout. That's a really good follow-up pick for the Hard Rock 3. If you win it, you go into another one. I feel this map a little more tapping than the Hard Rock 3, but still has plenty of slider aim, still has plenty of those tech map elements that you're expecting to see. And it's even almost an identical BPM, right? 182 for the Nomad 4 versus 180 for the Hard Rock 3. So if you just played one, you might as well play the next, because they're the same thing, with one with Hard Rock, one without.
One also having a bit more of a cut stream focus as well. A couple of finger control oriented patterns here and there. So while it is primarily slider aim, it's not all slider aim. These maps are very much, Hard Rock 3 and Nomad 4, very much alike.
Now with that in mind, you know, you wonder if any of the United Kingdom's trouble with the Hard Rock 3 was just because, you know, it's Hard Rock, it's slightly smaller circles, those types of things, the spacing gets a little increased. So, you know, with them performing almost well enough to win that, maybe on a Nomad 4 that, you know, tones those aspects of the map down just a tiny bit, maybe they'll be able to lock in a little bit better. But if you're Finland, you're not really thinking about that. You're thinking, we just want a tech map. Let's pick another one. Let's roll Freeze, Zepe, Amacetic, and Kadzax out there and see if we can't take two tech picks in a row and a nice quick 4-1 lead.
Yeah, consolidated breakpoint would be in Finland's best interest here. They'd have a lot. They'd have a lot of leniency to go around with that lead. Coming in as the underdogs in particular, be very relieved to have that sort of lead built up.
In we go, and you can see how tricky some of the slider aim in the early portions of this map can be. But we've seen a lot of players performing quite well in this. We've had several matches where there have been numerous FCs in these early goings. This one, still 6 through about 300 combo, make that 5. Plasma, Rouge, Amacetic, followed by Zepe. So 2-2, and a very closely fought affair in the first 400 combo or so.
Zepe, I believe, was actually a Bancho break.
Oh, so it was. You were right.
So, okay. I'm not too sure those were Bancho breaks, though. Right. Double break from Kadzak and Zepe. Majora does trade. Kingling is gone. 3 is the only combo remaining at all.
You know, you can get through that first 300 combo, but it's the next 200 combo that can really bite you. And unless your name is Freezed, you are not having the greatest of time. It's a few S ranks from those slider breaks, but they're combo breaks nonetheless. And that is well in favor of Finland, who have an FC and a little bit of a backing combo advantage to go along with it.
Not many people break here. No one, actually. Okay. So we get into the finger control intensive part here.
You're seeing yet more breaks. Zepe, Freeze, the Kadzax, Plasma, Rouge. And there goes Amacetic. It's a full reset for Finland. So if there was ever going to be an opportunity for the UK, it might just be now. Majora and Kingling, those are the players that I think they need to have really step up as things get tougher in this match. And in this pick, they are trying to do that. They are bringing this gap back as best they can. But there goes Majora, and it's just Kingling now.
It is very close, though. Kingling still holding on. Going to be shifting the score lead over the very end here. And I think he just might have done it.
He pulls through the entire outro. And that is Kingling taking the point for the United Kingdom. He steals it back after Finland had a lead through much of that map. Plasma with the S rank, but Kingling with the 500k, it is enough. And they take the break point right back. And like we said, these tech picks can be kind of volatile. And that was shown right there. Finland takes the break point on the Hard Rock 3 tech map, picks the Nomad tech map. UK says, no, we're going to take that one right back. And we are back in the swing of things now. 3-2 Finland in the lead, but the UK's pick to come.
Low AR hidden pick. I guess it kind of makes sense. Hidden 3 was banned out by Finland, so why not try your hand at the hidden maps? The UK have more than enough players for this type of map. Listia in particular, well known for being low AR extraordinaire.
That was like the original skill set, I feel, that Lystia became known for, right? Is low AR reading hidden type stuff. And I believe Plasma also very good at these types of maps. So this should be a solid roster for UK. I like this pick from them. And it switches things up a bit as well. You know, we go Hard Rock Tech, we go Nomad Tech. No, let's go somewhere completely different. Let's go an Amy low AR hidden that is going to force a completely different skill set, maybe a different roster out of these teams as well.
We're seeing Uzak come in for the first time, I believe, this match.
Believe that is correct. Oh, nope. Well, he was there for a few seconds. We saw his face, and that was all. Hopefully he doesn't let the door hit him on the way out.
Just wanted to pop in to say hi.
Great. Hey, guys, good luck. Okay, bye.
I respect it. I think now, though, finalized rosters. Lystia, Plasma, King, Ling, Rouge. Going against Zefe, Kadzax, Amasetic, and Desku.
I like the UK. I like their chances on this type of map with this roster, but people have been kind of prone to breaking on various patterns on this map. I know, you know, there was discussion about whether the approach rate needed to be raised, lowered, what needed to be done with spacing and overlapping to make it an appropriate difficulty for this, and ended up, I think, being more difficult than it looks, I guess.
For those unaware, this was originally, I believe, AR8, and barely anybody on the test player team could play it, so we had to buff the AR slightly.
Or nerf the AR is the case, maybe, I guess. I don't know how you want to look at that.
Yeah, I guess you could say nerf the AR.
You made it easier.
This is meant to be a low AR pick, so you made it easier.
And you can already see people having trouble all over the place. Okay, who actually still has an FC? Plasma, Lystia, and Desku, and that's it. We weren't even 100 combo in, and there are already 5 breaks. And there goes Desku.
Yep, there goes Desku. Lystia and Plasma, the two that we mentioned earlier. The only two really having a fun time on this map right now.
You know, mention this being harder than it looks, because nothing in this looks overtly mechanically challenging, but when you see players struggling as much as they are, I think it makes it pretty clear that this map is way trickier than it might seem at first glance. But Lystia and Plasma have a completely different thought process about this map, where they go into it and say, yes, we're going to casually just hold a large combo while nobody else can and give our team a good chance on the map, despite Kingling and Rude really struggling due to their lack of players to fill this skill set.
That actually could matter quite a bit if Plasma and Lystia find misses here. There goes Lystia, so one of the FCs gone from the side of the UK. If Plasma follows up shortly after, this could actually get quite dicey here. Just off Rouge and Kingling not having the best of times finding a consistent combo in this.
Yeah, when you're halfway through and somebody's at 90 ACK, 130k score, you can tell that it's a skill set that they're not meant to be playing. UK, fortunately thus far, getting kind of bailed out by Plasma and the earlier combo from Lystia, because Kingling and Rouge just cannot play this at all, unfortunately. And the fact that Finland has not been able to build up much combo. You see Zepe at 200-something, oh, he breaks. You see Amasetic getting 100-something, oh, he breaks as well. So UK being aided, not only by Plasma being a god, but also by Finland struggling quite heavily.
Kadzak as well, making a very nice recovery on the side of Finland. So if Plasma were to actually miss earlier, since now I don't really think it's going to matter too much, especially with Kadzak dropping that combo. Not going to matter at all now. It's just whether or not Plasma can secure that FC. But it could have been a bit dicey there, all things considered. Fortunately, working out in the UK's favor. There goes Plasma. Not going to matter. It's the very end of the map.
Would have been cool to see the FC after he comes in full combos the CS6.5 Hard Rock. To have him also FC the Air A.3 hidden would have been pretty neat. Unfortunately, it doesn't come to fruition, but it's a late one miss, and it ends up being a 500,000 point lead. I'm going to be the first to say that that didn't feel like a 500K win.
It started really going to that lead, sort of lead gap, mostly from Plasma at the very end there. The beginning stages of the map, I believe it was pretty much within 50K to 100K. It was mostly just that ending combo from Plasma just really took them over the goalpost there.
Also, shoutouts to Listia's 99% accuracy, because, you know, it's one thing to get that sort of combo with 95 ACK, but when you get the second best combo and you also have the best accuracy, get a little bit extra score out of it, make things a little bit more comfortable. And now we're back tied. It is 3-3. We've got 2 picks left per team. Still a decent amount of maps left, but it becomes harder and harder to figure out what skill set seems favored to a given team.
Well, let's just try generic maps. Why not? Free mod 4. I say generic, but it's within the realm of generic. Just like aim-oriented consistency. But at the same time, there's a lot of different variables that go into this map. A lot of changing BPMs in particular on this map, which can throw accuracies for a loop in particular. There's also a couple of slow slider sections in this, which are very hard to aim.
Yo, yeah, the kind of stop-start nature of those sections, it's like just past halfway, I guess, right? Where you have the short slow sliders into big jumps. Those can catch you out very easily if you're not comfortable. Also, just the big difficulty spike, I feel, in the last quarter of this map where there are some very, very difficult patterns. It is not a consistently comfortable pick because of the way it changes what it throws at you. But it is a banger, and that always helps. I feel like there's a little buff involved when you're playing a song that's this good.
A disturbing lack of English rock that's being ranked in Osu as a whole.
Well, maybe this free mod 1 will go for ranked, because you have this Sum 41 that's been kind of just languishing for a very long time, and now it's in the a World Cup pool, so maybe it'll get some more eyes on it. So we should push that one.
I'll make a few calls.
We're gonna see here. We've got Listia, Plasma, Kingling, Majora on the side of UK. Kadzax, Zepidescu. For Finland.
Imagine Kingling obviously going hard rock on this. I believe it'll probably be between Listia or Plasma to take the hidden. Then Majora, probably no mod on this. Not too sure what Finland would go for.
Let's see. I know they had Zepe and Descu were in on hard rock previously. Descu's going to overmod. He's going to go hidden hard rock, which means it looks like Kadzax is going to go hidden based on what we're seeing here. And then
Plasma hidden and Majora actually on the hard rock rather than Kingling.
It's interesting because I will always think of Kingling as a hard rock player, but obviously more than confident on Nomad as well, so not crazy. And Majora, you know, maybe one of the just higher skill cap players on that team. So with hard rock being the more difficult mod, just said, all right, let's go that route. We got an early break from Descu right at the very beginning. Not going to have much impact on the score. He's only about 20 combo behind, but it is worth noting. Other than that, everybody's settling into the first part of this map quite comfortably.
This is what I was saying is probably the most generic part of the map. Just generic aim, not really anything too crazy going on here. Maybe a couple of awkward angles here and there, but it's not anything to really write home about, and you can see that reflected in the scores. No one except Listia is going to be missing in the early stages of this map here.
It's really suboptimal, though, right? You don't want to be breaking in the first quarter to third of this map, because this is the easiest section. So it's setting yourself kind of unnecessarily behind to break in the first part here. And Finland looking to take a little advantage as they still are holding all four of their big combos as we go past the 1/3 mark into the slow section, which will then be followed up by the more difficult portions of this map.
the halfway point is where this map starts getting a bit more difficult.
See how people fare. It's a break from Kadzax on the slow section just before you get into these slow sliders.
Most
not what you
streams.
Want.
Streams.
Oh, and there goes.
Kingling does follow it up.
So we have Plasma and Majora against Zeppe and Dezku. Lystia, though, with a solid backing combo. Now we get some rhythm changes. We get some more difficult sections. We get a break from Zeppe.
Majora trades it. Dezku trades it as well. No FCs on the side of Finland. And Lystia and Plasma holding on to very strong combos. Going to be already 100k score difference just off those misses alone. And it's just going to keep on growing.
And this section gives you a little bit of relatively straightforward combo before you get into the last quarter of the map. Plasma and Lystia looking to bring this one on in for the UK. This section quite difficult. You see the break come in from Lystia as well as Dezku. It's traded. Majora finds the next miss as well as Yanmin and Kadzax.
Plasma.
Zeppe falls. Plasma.
It's a plasma show.
It is a plasma diff right now. What a performance this guy is putting on in this match. This is actually ridiculous. He is just putting the United Kingdom on his back.
Well, fourth of the map remaining. Let's see if he can close out the FC on this.
Yeah, he has done enough to give the UK an insurmountable lead pretty much regardless of what happens, but you really would love to see the guy put another FC down. After a little bit of heartbreak there on the low AR hidden, he comes into a normal AR hidden and puts on a show like this.
And that's going to be the FC.
Wow. Dude, Plasma's on another level this match. This is outrageous how well he is playing. That's a break point for the UK. They're going to take a 4-3 lead and will have the chance to advance onward to a match point if they can win their next pick. Plasma just putting down the law. He's laying down the law. He's got a 2.2 match cost so far. That is pretty darn good. And he passes the eye test as well as passing the statistical test.
I wonder what the UK picks here, actually. Speed hasn't been touched at all. Freemod 2, DT2, DT3 still up. But if they won Freemod 4 like that, and if Plasma is feeling confident, Hidden 1 could actually be a pretty good pick here, I think, for the UK.
Yeah, I was going to say, if you win that Freemod 4, I think it means that Freemod 1 and Hidden 1 both feel like pretty decent options. Hidden 1 being a little faster and a little streamier, Freemod 1 being a little more of the uncomfortable aim. Both, I think, would be pretty reasonable choices here for the United Kingdom, and they just throw Mr. Plasma at the other team and say, go for it, man. And that is going to be the Freemod 1. So we get back-to-back Western rock songs for probably, like, West. One of the first times this has ever happened in OWC.
West.
Let's go. Some 41, no reason. Map by FCL, the extreme difficulty. I feel like the name of the game here is just uncomfortable aim. There's linears, there's awkward angles, there's uncomfortable angles.
I'd be kind of surprised, actually, because I'd say a lot of the jumps on this look fairly uncomfortable, but they actually play fairly well. Like, a lot better than you would expect them to just from looking at them. So I'd say more just a generic aim consistency pick on this one. It's a section in the middle, though, in particular, that is fairly awkward. A lot of linear aim on that section prior to, I believe, a break.
There's a few, I think, places, right, where it does that kind of, you'll have a big aim section into, if not a break, like a slower, you know, it fits the song with it being Western rock. That's kind of how the song structure tends to go. So you do get chances to rest your aim just a little bit after the more intense aim sections. I'm just going to say, eyes on Plasma once again here, right? He's almost assuredly going to be the hidden player for the UK, and he's almost assuredly going to put up a very, very good score the way he's performing today. And Finland are going to have to try to find an answer because they're running out of points. Looks like on the side of Finland, it's going to be Kadzax, Tikkanen, Dezku, and Zeppe. Based on the previous map, that's Kadzax hidden. Maybe Dezku either hidden Hard Rock or Hard Rock only. UK Plasma hidden Majora Hard Rock. Just keeping with the tradition of the previous pick.
Yeah, they did not go for the hidden Hard Rock this time. I would be very surprised if they actually went hidden Hard Rock on this. This map is very difficult with Hard Rock, I'd say. I don't really think you'd be seeing many players really wanting to play this with Hard Rock and being particularly good at it either. I believe this is like 7.5 stars with Hard Rocks, which is quite hard.
Yeah, 7.45. Not easy with HR. Not easy at all. And yeah, it is just minimal mods. One hidden, one Hard Rock per team. Lystia, the first break, again, one of those very early breaks, doesn't amount to all that much.
Urge as well, also finding an early miss. So Finland will be having the early lead here.
We're going to build up into the first chorus. There's this common theme where you have a, you know, kind of a stream section, just like that, into the chorus, which has bigger aim, sometimes a little uncomfortable, or at least uncomfortable looking. But players not having too much trouble, except for the first break for Finland. It's going to be Kadzax.
Not traded by anyone on the side of UK for now. We clear the first chorus. Zeppe as well, missing at the tail end of the chorus. It's not going to be helping things at all.
And that's the Hard Rock FC gone as well. So losing some score for Finland's side. That score bonus, not going to be as meaningful. Okay, Majora, Lystia. Majora just straight over-aimed that little linear pattern. Not sure what Lystia broke on, but Zeppe traded one of them back. So it's Plasma and Rouge up against Dezku and Tikkanen. But there go Plasma and Tikkanen. This is getting interesting, to say the least.
There's still a pattern at the halfway mark, which I feel like if anyone combos is going to determine the outcome. It's coming up, like, I think right about now, and I want to see if anyone hits this.
You get squares, you get linears, you get breaks, but Dezku holds, Rouge also holds. Tikkanen and Plasma are matching, Rouge and Dezku are matching, but Dezku has the score advantage from Hidden that should help bring this score gap back over to Finland slowly.
There's still a chorus coming up here where misses can be traded. Let's see if that happens. Majora dropping a huge chain miss. Going to give the score lead over to Finland. The FCs are still holding, and that's the most important part here.
It's going to be Rouge and Plasma still against Dezku and Tikkanen, and there go Rouge and Plasma. They both fall, and that is going to be Finland taking the point. It's going to be tied up 4-4. Just like that, a huge score here from Dezku on Hidden. And Tikkanen with the solid backing score for the Finland side.
Dezku is going off right now, looking to secure the FC. Let's see if he can hit the ending.
Nope.
Not going to be hitting
note,
the ending.
The middle note of that giant linear pattern. It takes up the entire screen, and it's so easy to break. It's going to be a one miss from Dezku, unfortunately, right at the very end. But he more than did enough. And that is a solid victory for Finland. Tied 4-4, that means each team has one pick remaining after a couple more break points. Oh boy. Strap yourselves in, we could be on our way.
A tiebreaker potential.
To promised land. Oh boy.
Tiebreaker potential screaming out right now.
Let's see what we get ourselves here. Not a lot left. Got All the ones, except for now Freemod 1, you've got Gnomon 1, Hidden 1, Hard Rock 1, DT 1, all still up. DT 2 and DT 3, as well as FM 2. So all of the speed ended up being ignored in this match. Basically, I'm just going to say it's because UK doesn't have Malteser, and they don't feel comfortable going into speed with just Lystia and Majora. But it's going to be Finland last picking DT 1, so they're going to go the AIM double time pick. It is going to be their final selection for this match, Shinzo Cascade. The 7.16 star, 250 BPM, air 10.2, aim heavy, DT pick.
Couple of bursts here and there too, so. Still somewhat speed oriented. It's a lot more focused on your aim consistency as a whole.
We've seen a variety of results on this map. We've seen at least one or two FCs. We've also seen some not as great scores. It really does come down to that aim consistency. How well you can play that higher BPM aim. Of course, you have to be able to read air 10.2, which, if you're missing players, as the UK is today, who would typically be in for this type of map, you might be missing somebody who would play high AR. Got Jellychuffs coming out. With Kingling, Plasma, Rouge, Majora, so no Lystia, it looks like. Desku, Emacetic, Freeze, and Yamin for Finland. Of course, this is huge. Whoever wins this has a match point on the last pick. But the question is, will it be UK getting the match point on their own pick, or will it be Finland trying to get a break point to win? We'll find out in just over 2 minutes as we get into the final pick for Team Finland in DT1. See how comfortable the players are on the early stages of this pick to kind of try to determine whether they're well prepared for it, whether they have rosters that are comfortable with it. And so far, so good through 200 combo.
Yeah, so far, not having any issue. Okay, well, there goes Kingling and Freeze at the exact same time. Majora as well. Not answered by anyone inside of Finland, so slight combo advantage for Finland in the early stages here.
There's Amacetic and Plasma.
Majora with repeated misses. Not what you want to be seeing right now. It's two FCs to one and high combo now on Freeze, or well, relatively high combo. Kingling slider breaking that as well. That's the supporting combo gone. It's just Rouge.
It's just Rouge, and we're already halfway through. There go Freeze and Amacetic, but that really doesn't matter, because Desku and Yamin are holding. And as long as they've got both of them, there's really not much the UK can do. They're having a ton of trouble. I'm shocked to see Majora struggling hard.
Okay.
Wait, okay. Desku and Yamin both break, and this can come back really fast with Rouge. He is going to pull off the Korean Maluko if he can hold this full combo for a while, where he solo carries and brings it back for his team.
That score gap is closing very rapidly. It went from 200k now just to 100k, and still closing. As we get into a slow section here, 50k, 40k, and they're going to be seeing that at the break. Rouge knows he has to hold on here, and it is vital that he does. The score gap is going to shift. UK looking to get a break point off Rouge's FC here. Slider breaking on the first.
You hate to see it. Plasma, though, bringing home the big combo in the end. Majora with about a 350 combo as well. But this is all about Rouge on this pick. He held on when no one else could. Got them through the first three quarters of the map, and his teammates brought it home for him. Chapeau to Rouge for carrying that pick and giving the United Kingdom another breakpoint. That's three in a row, and it gives them a match point on their own pick, crucially. Despite that slider break at the end, an S rank, amazing performance in the clutch when he needed it most.
Now it's up to the UK for their final pick. What did they decide to go for? All that's really left is aim and speed.
It's got to be Hidden 1, right? It's got to be Hidden 1.
I'd say realistically speaking, that is probably what we will see. But if they are feeling like they can compete on the speed maps, Freemod 2 could be a potential possibility.
Also, there is a map that we've seen very little of today. I don't know that I've seen it played at all, and it's DT3. That map has just not really been around very much, and it's kind of a hybrid of a DT1 and a DT2, right? Where it's a little aimier than a traditional DT2, but it's got a lot more speed than a traditional DT1. So if you feel like that skill set might work for you the way that it just did on DT1, that could be an option. But this is a big decision for the UK to have to make right now. They're taking their time on it. They want to make sure that this is optimal. And it is. It's going to be the hidden one. So I think we were right on with that. It's hidden. It's got aim. It's got some streams. It's got a little bit of reading, not a whole lot of reading, beyond, you know, the basic reading of having hidden on.
Considering how well Plasma has been doing with hidden throughout this entire match, it's not really that surprising to see this picked up. Finland have their work cut out for them on this map, I think.
Yeah, this, the way that UK has looked on aim as well as on some of the hidden, this feels like a very, very strong pick for them in this situation. You have Rouge fresh off of carrying DT1 if he's in for this. You have Plasma, who's been amazing on hidden aim. But, man, you get to this stage of the match, the last map before maybe going to a tiebreaker, and the nerves just reach a fever pitch, and that can play a role as well.
Waiting on a fourth player for Team Finland here, and then we'll get right underway. I think UK roster of Lystia, Plasma, Rouge, and Majora is pretty set in stone.
Yeah, because it wasn't going to be Kingling, right? So that was the only like other player they have. So kind of wishing they had maybe Blue, but fortunately not going to be available. Or maybe Mahmood. I don't know for sure what he plays on this team, on this type of, whether he would be in for this type of map. Hadzex, Sepe Desku, going to be joined by Isak, it looks like, which... We mentioned earlier that he was in and didn't end up playing. It would have been his first map then. So this is actually going to be his first match. Or map, excuse me.
First map, and it's the last pick.
Yeah, no pressure.
No pressure.
Just come in to try to send us to a tiebreaker. No big deal, guys. Tournament lives on the line. No pressure, man.
Well, relatively short pick. 2 minutes long. So early misses are going to be mattering somewhat more than your traditional 3 minute long map.
Gotta watch out for that perfect stack as well as the slider stream kind of in this first portion. Oh my god!
Everybody except this guy. Oh my god!
Alright, well, it actually doesn't matter because everyone missed, right?
It's just Lystia that did it.
Just Lystia. What did we just watch? Oh my lord.
It's Lystia. Oh! Okay, well, there goes that. Never mind. Goodbye.
But there goes Zepe as well. There goes Zepe, so it is traded. So Plasma, Rouge, Isak, and Desku. There goes Kadzax. It's not traded. It's not traded. There goes Majora, but that's not the important combo. It's Plasma and Rouge that are the ones that matter. Isak and Desku are matching, or roughly matching, but they both break!
No combo on the side of Team Finland. Plasma and Rouge still holding on halfway through the map. The score gap is just going to keep on increasing. 200k and growing.
And they hold through this stream. No, they both break on it! Oh my goodness! It's 200k, there's a full third of the map to go, and there's no combo on the UK! Kadzax as well as Isak Dezku and Zeppe really are all building up at least some combo. It does get hard again after these sliders. UK has to kind of sit back and think about what they've done for a moment before the map really starts up again in earnest. But that score gap is going to be dwindling fast.
We're going to need to see a bit more misses from the UK. Listia does start, but it's going to need a lot more than that because Isak does trade
it. Oh no, I don't think it needs much anymore. Kadzax and Dezku are still holding. Plasma
can they hold through this? Dezku's gone. Kadzax still holding, but it's not going to be enough.
Oh my goodness. Just, it looked for the world like that could come back to Finland. But the UK, in the end, with Plasma Majora holding some combo into the ending, Rouge and Listia putting up their scores as well. By just a margin of 100k, the United Kingdom take the point. They take the match. That's the final. 6-4, Finland are sent home, and UK will head onward into the next round of Loser's Bracket. Man, what a match.
The UK going on to face against China now in the next quarterfinals matchup. Still have one more match that they have to play this weekend, and that will be happening tomorrow. They stay alive in the tournament for now, though. Missing three players, getting a bit close at the couple of picks there. Still managing to claw out the win nonetheless.
Yeah, that was scary for the UK with those missing players. You could tell they were struggling on some picks at times. They got kind of bailed out here and there by heroic performances, but that was well done for the UK, and unfortunately someone's got to go home, and it's Finland. So they're going to drop out top 24. No shame in that. 23rd seed, top 24.